First of all, let's take a look at what happens when you install notifications. You'll notice that notifications is not installed on this particular machine, and you can tell that by looking at the Pi System Explorer. See, take a look down here. We don't see in this pane down here, we don't see notifications listed. That indicates to me notifications is not installed or associated with this AF server. So let me just minimize that. I'm going to go ahead and do the install for notifications. Now I've got the notification setup right here. I'll just go ahead and run the setup. We're going to be prompted for several different servers that we're going to be required to identify. For example, the AF server and any Webparts server that might be involved, an IIS server for the notifications acknowledgement, that kind of thing. So that's all coming up. We'll see that as we go through the install. Okay, that's going to be the default directory. I'll take that. In fact, I'm going to take the default for a lot of these things. Now, here are the different things that I can install. As we described earlier, there's three parts of this, the client, the service, and then this acknowledgement page. We're going to install all of them in this case. Now, we're being prompted here for the name of the AF server, and it's just gone out and it's found the default. Now, in this environment right here, we've got a very simplistic install. I've only got one AF server in this environment. And that's this one called OSIsoft TRNG. In fact, that's the name of all the servers. That's the same machine that we're using for SMTP, for sending email. It's our web server for the Pi notifications that we're going to be using, the notifications acknowledgement page. And it's also our Pi Webparts server. So we're going to see that server name a lot during this particular install. Everything's being self-contained on a single machine. And speaking of single machine, if you're using this, you know, this AF server on the same machine as notifications, then you can get away with using local system. If you are going across from an AF server on a different machine, then typically what you're going to be using is a domain user. Now, if you are choosing the domain user option because you are installing this on a machine that is not the same machine as your AF server, then make sure that that domain user does have administrative privileges to run AF. Here's the spot where we get a lot of different things we have to answer here. We need to specify what is the Pi server that's going to be carrying the historization of the notifications. So this is where we're looking for the name of the Pi server. And again, as I said, this particular server here, OSIsoft Training, it's going to be used over and over again. That is our Pi server here. It is also our SMTP server. So I'm going to go ahead and make reference to that. Now that's if you're going to be using the email notification or email delivery channel, which it would be a real stretch to imagine you're going to go to all the trouble of installing notifications and you're not doing any email notification. If you are only using specific delivery channels, oh, like XML or something that you've written yourself, then I could see not using an SMTP server for email. But, you know, this is overwhelmingly what the majority of our users are going to be doing. So that's going to be the SMTP server. It just needs to be a machine that you have access to within your environment. Now, we do recommend that you come up with some kind of an email address. I'm just going to go with training@osisoft.com. Everything that we send via notifications is going to have that as the sender name. Now, at this point, if you have a Webparts server, now this is where you can go ahead and specify what that server name is. Well, we do have a Webparts server, and hey, guess what? It's the same server that we've used for everything else. So this is a real simple installation here. So I'm going to go ahead and specify that. It could be something it could be something that's on your network. It doesn't have to be the same server, obviously. Now, there is one thing about this Webparts server. It does have to be a fully qualified domain name. So in my case, it's osisofttraining.osisoft.int. Yeah, so that is a requirement that you specify the fully qualified name. I'll go ahead and say next. Now, I should point out, in general, if you accept the defaults, you should be good here, because what we're doing here is we're specifying what virtual directories are going to be installed on the IIS machine that you're using if you're using that notifications acknowledgement page. And you have the option to change the defaults if you want. But and if you're not the person who's familiar with IIS, you know, your web server, you might want to get them involved at this point. But just choosing the defaults should work. Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and specify we're going to change or choose the default website. This particular a copy of IIS on this machine is running several web servers. And I'm going to go ahead and or websites, I should say. And I'm going to go ahead and specify the default. And this is going to be the name, the virtual directory name that's going to be created. Now I'm going to go ahead and leave the default virtual directory name and also the default for this parent here. Now right here, this physical directory is telling us where we're going to be installing this acknowledgement page, or the basically the support files for this acknowledgement page. That's what we're doing in this particular screen here. We're specifying for IIS's purpose, for the web service purposes, you know, things about that acknowledgement page. I'll go ahead and click on Next. And it looks like everything's been answered at this point, so I'll go ahead and choose Next and wait for the installation to finish. Now the big finish to this, the grand finale, should be when we're finished, we should be able to launch this PySystem Explorer and see that there's been a new option added to the pane down at the bottom. That's going to be the notification shows up for the first time. Okay, it looks like the notification was installed properly. I'll go ahead and finish. And as I said, the grand finale to this would be to launch the PySystem Explorer. It's under PySystem. And to take a look and see if we've added notifications. And there we go. Take a look down here. We can see two new things have been added, notifications and then contacts. The contacts are going to be part of the notifications.